Is it possible to build a large language model entirely from scratch?
But before we get there, let's go back to the beginning. Hi, I'm Sujar. I'm a 20-year-old computer science student, but I didn't grow up in Silicon Valley surrounded by million-dollar startups. I grew up on a small Caribbean island with a slow internet connection and an even slower laptop. I'm not some math prodigy, I didn't score high on the SAT, I didn't go to a top university, and I definitely don't have a PhD. But here's the thing, I'm about to try something that OpenAI researchers are being paid millions to figure out. Once you understand how these systems work, you'll have the same skills that are making these researchers incredibly valuable. The same skills that are making them millions of dollars, and the same skills that companies are practically fighting over. And here's the crazy part. Our education system still teaches us old software, the same legacy code that's flooding the government systems, and the same legacy code that's slowing down the older tech companies. But I want to try and change that. And you can see it as well. No one's paying hundreds of millions of dollars for COBOL or assembly developers. The hard truth is that AI is the future. And companies know that if they have to pay millions of dollars to one developer to achieve their goal, they're gonna do that. So that's exactly why I'm going to build an LLM from scratch to learn these million-dollar skills. This isn't about opening up ChatGPT, making a wrapper, and saying that I built a language model. I'm talking about building something that can actually understand language and generate responses from the ground up. We're gonna learn about neural networks, transformers, attention mechanisms, tokenization, and a ton of other topics. And here's the thing, I don't even know if this is possible for me. I might crash and burn halfway through, but that's the entire point. Everything you see in life doesn't happen as smoothly as it does in social media, and some things just don't end up working. You're going to see every success, every mistake, and every single time that I mess up because I didn't know any better. And if we actually pull this off, you would have learned these million-dollar skills without actually having to pay for a PhD. And I know I'll have some critics that are saying that I'm wasting my time and I should just fine-tune a model instead, but if every single person thought this way, no one would dare to try to learn anything new. It's kind of like if we told everyone who's building websites to just leave HTML and JavaScript to the professionals and just use drag and drop tools instead. If we did this, we wouldn't have any more web developers. So if you want to follow along with my journey, make sure to hit the subscribe button down below so you don't miss the next parts, and make sure to drop a comment down below and let me know what suggestions you have for the future episodes. And I'll see you in the next one.